So in this video, I'm going to be talking about my personal experiences of dental core training, DCT1 in maxillofacial surgery, and hopefully explaining some things which I wish someone had told me when I just started, because I found the transition to be quite steep and the learning curve to be very steep. So a bit about me and my background. Before I started doing dental core training, I was actually in practice for around 2 years. I've locumed a lot in a lot of different practices because I hadn't found a practice that I wanted to stay in. So essentially DCT, dental core training, is something you need to have if you want to specialize in dentistry, or for some people after they've done their dental foundation training year and they're not sure if they want to go into practice, or they don't feel so confident, or they are not sure if they want to specialize and go into hospital training, this DCT year is a great year to help them make that choice. So is there any point in doing DCT in Maxfac if you don't want to do maxillofacial surgery to do medicine, or if you don't know if you want to specialize in a dental specialty? So for me personally, I went into DCT because I wanted that experience of working in a hospital setting to learn more about the medical management of patients and to see what it's like working in a hospital setting. So I think that in itself was a valuable experience for me. And I think if you're undecided or you're not completely 100% sure what you want to do, it is a valuable experience. I do think that if you have, you know, worked in practice for a couple of years like I did, I worked for 2 years and then I found I just wanted something else, I wanted an experience of something else, I think that is also okay to take a year out, because it's a really great opportunity and I think you will learn a lot from it. It does make sense to do DCT a little bit more early on in your career. However, if you have been doing practice for a little while and you feel that you want to explore something else, I think that's absolutely fine, and you going back to DCT1 is not the end of the world. To apply for DCT, it's through national recruitment, just like Dental Foundation, and so you rank all the places which you would consider, and then based on your SJT and your interview, you are allocated a job post. It's a good idea to only rank those posts that you would be interested in doing, and I think it is important to consider your location because the job is intense, it can be intense, it's long hours, so you want to be somewhere where you will enjoy living for 12 months or not hate. So what are the actual roles which you might be undertaking in DCT Maxfac? So your schedule will be varied. Every week your rota is different and you'll be on a different shift. So for example, one day you might be on the ward. So this means you're looking after all the Maxfac patients on your ward. So these are patients coming in before their surgery, or patients who have had their surgery and they need care, or patients who are admitted but they don't need surgery but they still need hospital management. So you'd be doing things like requesting x-rays, taking blood, liaising with the different teams like nurses, dietitians, speech and language therapists, radiology, microbiology, for the care of that patient, because they may need input from a different team. So it's your job to correspond and liaise with them. You will also be doing administrative tasks, so lots of things on the computers. For example, the discharge summary for patients. So that's when a patient is ready to be discharged from hospital. You need to document, you know, their stay, the reasons why they've stayed, what operation they've had, if they have, and send this to the GP. In the morning, you'll do a ward round. So what this means is you will go with the consultant on call with the middle grade registrars. So and also some of your colleagues, other DCTs, and you will go see all the Maxfac patients in the whole hospital, so not just on your ward, they might be elsewhere as well. And so you will be reviewing them on a daily basis to see what investigations they may need, if they're fit and ready for discharge, and essentially how they're doing. It's just a daily kind of review of these patients. Another job you might do is assisting in theatres. So in maxillofacial surgery, there's actually a lot of different subspecialties. So for example, you might be in oncology theatres doing big head and neck cancer cases or smaller cases, and you'll be helping assisting in those. You might be in TMJ theatres or deformities, so things like cleft palate. There are also extractionalists, so patients needing extractions under general anaesthetic. So for difficult surgical extractions like wisdom teeth, impacted canines, ectopic canines, pediatric patients needing exposure and bonding of canines for orthodontic treatment. Another theatre list you might be helping is the emergency theatre list, and this is the list which isn't elective and planned, but these are emergency patients who have come in that week and they need an operation. So broken mandibles, if they've got swelling of their neck from a dental infection, you'd be helping to assist those emergency operations. Some weeks you will be on call, so what that means is you'll be in the emergency department in ED, and you'll be seeing patients who come in with emergencies such as swellings, facial trauma, maybe TMJ problems and lacerations. Usually those are the things you would see. So when you're on call, you take referrals from the different departments, so from different specialties you may get a call about a patient, or in emergency department they will call you asking if they can refer a patient for you to see, or maybe from a dentist or a GP they'll call you to refer a patient, and it's up to you to see if this patient truly has a maxillofacial problem which is acute and urgent and requires immediate treatment and hospital admission, or whether they're more suitable for, say, an outpatient clinic, or this is something the dentist or GP can manage. At first, I think on call can seem very daunting because often you're presented with cases which you've never seen from DF, from practice, and you have to manage these patients medically. But with experience and with seeing similar cases, you start to understand what kind of investigations you need and how to make this management plan. If you're ever unsure about how to manage a patient or what you should do or how to interpret an x-ray, there is the registrar on call who is above you, who you need to go to consult and just ask them for advice. That's their job, so you shouldn't feel afraid to approach them. One of the biggest differences about working in dental practice and in a hospital setting is that in the hospital you are working as part of a much bigger team, and you need to liaise with all the different specialties for the care of your patient. Whereas in dental practice, you have a lot more responsibility for your patient, so you're responsible for examining and assessing them, doing the investigations, formulating a treatment plan, thinking about your management, as well as carrying out the treatment and maybe some admin. Whereas in the hospital, essentially the patients are the consultant's patients, so you will be part of a big team to organize lots of different things for these patients, so investigations, carrying out part of the treatment plan, assisting in their surgery, arranging their aftercare. So it's different in that sense. I also think working in a hospital can be a slower pace. So when you're on the ward, when you're on the clinic, you can be busy, but it's a different intensity to that of dental practice, where you're seeing patients after patients, except for a lunch break, and you're constantly doing, you know, treatment, exams. So I would say the intensity and pace of being in a hospital is slower than being in dental practice, except when you're on call. In your role as a DCT1 in maxillofacial, you will not be expected to make lots of big decisions regarding patient treatment and care, because that's a decision to be made on a more senior level where obviously they have a lot more experience than you. But as you learn more and as you progress, you will be expected to make more decisions, but you always have someone to consult or ask for advice and guidance when you need it. Another big difference between DCT and working in practice is that as a DCT, you will be salaried, whereas in practice, you are self-employed. So how much you earn depends on how much activity you carry out, how much dental treatment you do. So I think because DCT is salaried, it's good in that you can just spend time to really understand, to really gain knowledge and learn as much as you can from the experience without having additional pressure of finance. So I think that is actually a really good advantage. For me, some of the best parts of DCT have been working with my colleagues. I've actually really enjoyed working in a big team with other DCTs, with the registrars and consultants. There have been some real characters and it's been a really fun year. I am very grateful to have been able to do this year of DCT in maxillofacial surgery, essentially doing the role similar to that of a junior doctor without having done medicine. It's been a really great opportunity and I've been able to see so many different things, completely different from practice. I've really enjoyed, you know, learning about anatomy and seeing the anatomy from doing the operations, assisting in the operations, being close up when the consultants and registrars are operating. And in dental school, you learn a little bit about anatomy, you do maybe the cadaver dissections, but it's not the same. And it just, you really learn a lot from this year. And I've really enjoyed being on call as well. And I just feel like I am much better equipped for dental practice now in terms of dealing with, you know, medically unwell patients or when to refer patients in for suspected oral cancer. And I just feel more confident as a clinician in a more rounded way and better with extractions as well. I hope you found this video insightful and useful in helping you to decide whether or not DCT in maxillofacial surgery is something which you would like to do. If you have any questions for me, you can always leave it down below in the comment section. Thank you for watching.